essentially what we've had over the last few hours is more bombing of the Hezbollah bases, and we know that the majority of the Hezbollah leadership have now been taken out, but we also have this now. Because the head of military, of course, has now actually, well, the lieutenant general has come out to say that you can hear the planes here. We are attacking all day, both to prepare the ground for the possibility of your entry, but also to continue striking Hezbollah. This is according to the latest statement issued by the military themselves, and of course, the IDF chief said that we are preparing for a ground maneuver in Lebanon. The goal is to return the residents to the north of Israel. Now, let's not forget that for months and months, almost a year, a lot of people in the northern part of Israel have been displaced. They're not even allowed to go back to their homes because of the attacks coming from the northern part of Israel. But we have some good news for those people. A lot of people who are against Islamism and the puppets of the Islamic Republic. Why? Because a lot of them are being eliminated left, right and centre, ladies and gentlemen. So, this is the chart showing the leadership of Hezbollah. We are still waiting for the full confirmation when it comes to Ali Karaki, the commander of the Southern Front, because his body has still not been discovered. But everybody else has already been eliminated. We see the gap, and this is every single person on the top of the Hezbollah brigade that has now been eliminated. So essentially, that means that Hassan Nasrallah, as the leader of Hezbollah, is just having meetings on his own because all his friends are gone. So it's a little bit embarrassing, of course, for the Iranian regime, who've been building up this organization for a decade, and now it's been a massive failure. The one time that they've been given everything to attack Israel with, well, they've done a bit of a whoopsie, haven't they? So we also have, of course, the latest update when it comes to civilians in Lebanon. They have, of course, listened to the IDF and their heads up. We now have 500,000 Lebanese citizens also in the southern part of Lebanon. Hezbollah wants to have the amount of this because usually it is. We've always said, of course, general tactics that they have, the same guard. They tell civilians not to leave, sometimes they force people not to leave. And the idea is to basically use civilians as human shields. And in this case, people in Lebanon say, we want nothing to do with this, we do not want to risk our lives for Hezbollah, so we're out. And that's what they are already doing. We also have confirmation of the next elimination. 512 minions of Hezbollah have now been taken out. This is the latest face, smiley face, is no longer smiling, ladies and gentlemen. Every single person is now gone, apart from one main battler. That's Hassan Nasrallah. Obviously, over the next few hours, we are expecting the possible invasion of the southern border of Lebanon. And of course, a lot of it will be occupied by the Christians in Lebanon, who want Hezbollah to get out quickly. What? Gaza, where the reservoir from the 1st 152nd Division conducted several raids. Terrorists who hijack parts of Lebanon, and but it's a necessity, mostly because whether you like it or not, the Lebanese government essentially surrendered because they've given up. They said, "Well, Hezbollah is here now. What are we going to do about it?" They did not hit it. They've been hosting. So essentially, not necessarily they've directed the Lebanese fault, but there have been people in the Lebanese establishment that allowed this to happen.
Yeah.
course, and commemoration there in terms of what's been happening in terms of the actual Hebrew calendar as well. Today a lot is 1 year on from the 7th of October, but it might have taken a year. But both in Gaza and in Lebanon, the operation has been successful. And when it comes to Hezbollah and Lebanon, it hasn't really been a year directly. Yes, Hezbollah started the missiles and rockets almost immediately after Israel started their counter-terrorism operation in Gaza. But in reality, the actual direct reaction to counter-attack from Israel in Lebanon has been going on less than a year. So both successful because the only two people left on both sides are Yahya Sinwar in Gaza, apparently, might be somewhere else already, might be in Egypt, you never know, and Hassan Nasrallah in Lebanon. Both of them hiding deep in a cave or a tunnel somewhere, and we're still not sure where they are. But at this point, it doesn't matter because obviously, in terms of political victory, it will be important for the IDF to capture those two. They will take them out because then they can say these were the heads that take this over. But the infrastructure is already destroyed, and now it has to be about what's going to happen next because hostages. Let's not forget about the hostages. It's all about them right now. And of course, when it comes to Hezbollah, it's about all those people who live in the northern part of Israel who've had to leave their homes for the past few months. Despite the fact that the media in the West are not telling you that much, they don't really even talk about the hostages, really. Even the Prime Minister in this country is not talking about the hostages, he's talking about sausages. So he's more interested in what's going on with sausages rather than hostages. And again, one of the main issues is that we have to wait and see the main reaction of the Israeli. That is the main key area. And right now, over the last couple of days, Iran has come out basically beg Israel to stop this, that we can stop this, let's not do a conflict. And they've gone to the Americans saying, can we start negotiations when it comes to nuclear? Because they know that Donald Trump is coming in potentially any moment over the next few months. And they ideally want to do something to preserve their own infrastructure because it's all about them. They don't care. The Iranian regime, the people at the top of the Iranian regime, are a bunch of greedy people who simply care about their own survival. They're not going to become martyrs. They do not want to become martyrs. Just like Yahya Sinwar, just like Hassan Nasrallah. They brainwash all the others. Everybody else could become martyrs, but now they themselves have to survive. They're going to go away. They're going to, even if they have to go to Venezuela, or Cuba, or North Korea, or Russia, wherever they're going to go, any sort of ally that they could have to take, they would. They're not going to do at all. Last minute, essentially, take his own life. They're not going to do that. If he did that, but again, everything's about the next few hours and the next day. As usual, thank you so much for watching. I'm Maya TC. We are.
No pain, no gain. That is coming from the Shaolin Temple. Work like no one at center. All the suffering is your chance to grow. I do not mix up. One day this teaching, second day this teaching, you stay with one thing. And then you let time do the work. You want to save yourself, save others. You want to save all others, save yourself. Welcome back to More Than This. Today's video, as always, was sponsored by Huel. I produce your black edition, which has 26 vitamins and minerals, 35 grams of protein, and so many carbs to make sure that I can stay satiated and protein up whilst I make these documentaries. Don't forget to leave them in the description. I'll talk about them a little bit later in the video.
How do we find peace?
I'm happy you didn't ask how we find happiness. Because in my search, in a way, I stopped searching for that term or the fulfillment. There is movement in whatever direction, doesn't matter. Wherever you have movement, you always have total movement. It is the picture if you have a lake, an ocean, and that ocean is still, but the water is standing still. If you start to tap on it, you will have up ripples and down ripples. If you don't get up ripples, you cannot touch it. And very similar, it is now with that idea of if you think happiness is something which is uprising, then it just means in the moment you feel that uprising, sooner or later you will feel a counterforce, which is the decline of something. So, no, happiness is not what you're looking for. But peace is something different. Peace for me is there is something unmovable, unshakable inside of you, regardless of the circumstance. So you found a place that you can recognize. Where you see there is nothing fluctuating regardless of what's happening out there. Because you found something about you. You found something that nothing can be added to it because it's complete already, and nothing can be taken away from it because there's nothing you can lose. If something like this starts to arise in the way of your perception, I think that is it. That is the state which is on you. If you feel peaceful, it is peaceful and gives you that peace of mind. Because what should you worry about if there's nothing to worry? Of course, no, many people say, yeah, but I have a child that I need to take care of. This is not for all. This is at the moment not for all. Not now. Thank you. you're in the land where you can actually try to do a lot of things as long as you abide to the rules without harming anyone. But one of these moments was that I sometimes like to ride motorcycle, so over in Thailand I also had like a scooter that I rented. And now just imagine